Next question, children. They're asking us to construct a parallelogram MORE. More. Given OR is 6 cm, RE is 4.5 and EO is 7.5 cm. But here, they have to give 4 sides of the parallelogram and 1 diagonal. But look, only 3 measurements are given. In the previous problems and all, including all the 4 sides, diagonal measurement also was given. But here only 3 measurements are given. How can we construct a quadrilateral or a parallelogram? Maybe crack in your mind. So children, in this case, you have to remember the properties of a parallelogram. One of the properties say that the opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel and equal. Yes, no? So using that property, children, suppose if we consider EO as the diagonal, then OR and RE becomes the two sides of the parallelogram. Since opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, OR na innon side, RE opposite side equal anta, we should take the same measurement. This is the reason I said you should remember all the properties of the quadrilaterals, all the quadrilaterals, parallelogram, trapezium, rhombus, kite, all the properties you should know, children. So as usual, first we should draw the triangle, construct the triangle, and then transfer it into a parallelogram by constructing the fourth vertex. Here, what we shall do is MORE andre, I will just write roughly MORE. Now, OE and MR are the diagonals, alva? MORE atwa MORE, either way you want, you can take. Why I am showing this is either OE or MR can be drawn as the diagonal. So now MR kottidara kottilla, so which is the one more diagonal given? OE. So this diagonal is given to us, children. So we shall first construct that triangle and then go to the construction of parallelogram. So we shall draw the rough sketch now. As I said, EO is the diagonal. So what we will do is first construct the triangle, so keeping the diagonal as the base. So I will label this as EO or OE, either way you can draw. OE, which is 7.5 cm line, I will draw. Next, illi OM gotirbeku illa ME gotirbeku. Do we know? No, we don't know, but we know what is OR. So from O, I can one more vertex I can mark, that is R. Similarly, from E to R I should know. Yes, that is also I know RE. So what I'll do now is, since OR is 6 cm, with the help of compass, measure 6, cut an arc. Again, with the help of compass, measure RE, which is 4.5 cm, cut an arc and join. This is 6 cm, this is 4.5 cm. Hence, we got the triangle. Now, we should make it a parallelogram. But we don't know what is M. Vertex M should come here. Alva, MORE, they have said here. Parallelogram MORE. So ORE bantu andre other vertex is M anta, you should understand. Do we know what is OM? No, we don't know. Do we know what is ME? No, we don't know. But we know, children, the opposite sides of the parallelogram are equal. Using that property, for the side RE, which is the opposite side, MO is the opposite side, and hence this should be 4.5 cm. Opposite to side RO is ME, which is again idu 6 andra idu 6, idu 4.5 andra idu 4.5. Hence we get MORE as the required parallelogram. Hope you have understood. Opposite side, opposite to RO eno ME, so adu 6, idu 6 andre idu 6 agirbeku, idu 4.5 andre adar opposite idu 4.5 agirbeku. Thus we will get the required parallelogram. So first what we shall do is, with the help of scale, let us draw the diagonal OE, which is 7.5 cm. So I joined OE, which is equal to 7.5 cm. Next, I need to construct the side OE, which is 4.5. So I will take the compass and measure 4.5 cm. Yes. So now I will keep the compass at E and cut an arc of 4.5 cm. Now this is 6 cm. Length OR is 6 cm. Again take the scale and measure 6 cm. Yes. Keep it at point O keep it at point O and cut an arc so that both the arcs will go inside. Look, now both the arcs coincide or intersected where? Here, and this is our vertex R. Next, since both the, so this intersecting point, join OR and RE with the help of scale. So thus we got triangle ORE, children. Next, according to our rough sketch, we need to plot this vertex M by constructing ME, which is 6 cm, OM 5. Now you can understand, I think. Now if you construct the parallelogram, children, opposite side, these two are opposite sides, these two are opposite side. Opposite sides are equal. Hence, we need to construct one, cut one more arc of 6 cm and 4.5 cm, and that becomes the opposite sides of the parallelogram. So next, I think this is 6 exactly still. Yes, it is 6 only, children. Which is 6? If this is 6, means either the opposite side bandhu EM. So this is, should be 6 cm. Thus I cutted an arc of 6 cm. Next, opposite to this is 4.5 cm. Again with the help of scale, I will measure 4.5 cm. And I will keep it at O and cut an arc. But unluckily, these two arcs are not meeting, means again I should measure 6 cm. 6 cm, keep it at E and construct once again. Look, now the arcs intersected at one point, and this point is our M, children. Now with the help of scale, join OM, ME. So after joining, this is what you get, children. MORE is the required parallelogram in which the opposite sides are equal and parallel, and OE is the diagonal. So this is the required parallelogram MORE. So this is about the third problem. We shall solve the last problem of this exercise, that is construction of the rhombus. The last problem of this exercise is, they have asked us to construct a rhombus, best, that is BEST, and side BE is 4.5 cm and ET is 6 cm is given to you. Look, now they are asking us to construct a rhombus. Rhombus is of course a quadrilateral with 4 sides, but only 2 sides are given. Again, children, as we did in case of the parallelogram, here also you should remember the property or recall the property of the rhombus. In a rhombus, all the 4 sides are equal. So roughly I have drawn the rhombus here, BEST, the same labeling I have given. So if this is the parallelogram, then all the sides, children, BE is equal to ES, is equal to ST, is equal to BT, is equal to how much? 4.5 cm. So this ET, it becomes the diagonal. ET becomes the diagonal, which is 6 cm. But all the other 4 sides are equal to 4.5, 4.5, 4.5 and 4.5 cm. Like this, all the 4 sides are equal in case of the rhombus. So all the 4 sides are equal to, given one of its side BE, which is 4.5 cm, whereas ET is the diagonal, which is 6 cm. So first, as usual, we shall construct the triangle BET and then plot the vertex S. This construction is very easy. Why? Once if you measure the compass using 4.5 cm, whole thing you can construct. So first we shall draw the line, that is the baseline of the diagonal, which is ET 6 cm. So I draw the baseline ET according to our rough sketch. Next, these two sides of 4.5 cm we need to construct. For that, take the compass and measure 4.5 cm. So it is exact 4.5. Don't change the measurement. One arc from T and one arc from E, both measure the same, no, children? So with the same measurement, I can cut both the arcs. Now what you do is, this intersecting point of two arcs is there. Now from there, join these two sides. That gives you the triangle. Now my compass still measure 4.5. I will keep the same measurement at T and cut one arc. Same measurement at E and cut one more arc. Now these two points also are coinciding at one point, and that is S according to our rough sketch and this is B according to our rough sketch. Now join all the four sides with the help of scale. Thus we got the rhombus BEST, that is the best rhombus we got, children, with all the four sides measuring 4.5 cm and diagonal 6 cm according to the given data and our rough sketch. So this is how you will construct a quadrilateral, any quadrilateral, maybe a parallelogram, rhombus or a rectangle given all the four sides and one diagonal. First we should construct the triangle and then construct the quadrilateral according to the measurements. In case of rhombus and parallelogram, you should apply the property so that you will know the remaining sides according to the given data. This completes the first exercise 7.1, children.